So now that we're logged in, we have the question of what to do with this user information. Well, our login method actually returns a mobile service user method, or a mobile service user class. And so that user right there is going to be how we manage our user information, obviously. We've got in there a user ID and then a mobile service authentication token. Now, the user ID comes from our IDP, so maybe Twitter or Google or whatever we actually use to authenticate against. And so that means that we don't really have any insight into it. It's kind of just a GUID, just an identifier. And in fact, if you were to log in with Google and Twitter with the same email address, you'd get different user IDs because obviously they're not coordinating user IDs together with each other. The mobile service authentication token, on the other hand, is our resource token. That's that JWT that we got back from Azure, from our Azure app service, and it's that ends up in the header going back to authenticate us. Notice these are both settable. Now, this is interesting and actually very important because the settability is how we're going to restore state later on. So when we actually have logged off or closed our application, we come back later, we don't want to have to go through the Twitter login process or the Google login process every time. If we've already got a token that's still valid, we'd like to just restore that. Well, we can by instantiating mobile service user and then setting those values. We can always tell if we're currently logged in, if we have logged in, by checking to see if there is a current user, if there is a mobile client user currently in that current user property. And then of course, if there's not, we might want to restore the state if we have some stored in our, if we have some data stored away for who should be logged in. Now, of course, because the user properties are settable, it's pretty easy to actually do the restoring of state. The difficulty comes in how to store our tokens. Remember that our tokens essentially represent the same amount of risk as a username and password, or very close to it, because with that token, you can act on behalf of the user. It's basically like having the user's username and password in a lot of ways, which means we need to be very careful with how we store it. Now, we do have several approaches for this, and we talk about them more in our ENT170 class. However, we need to look at it a little bit today because it's something that's a requirement in order to interact fully with our Azure mobile services. So some options are, of course, going to be, and probably the best options, are to use the platform-specific solution. So Windows has the password vault, Android the key store, iOS has the key chain. These are the platform-specific secure ways to store secret data. Now, of course, being Xamarin developers, we always want some platform agnostic wrapper to handle things for us so we can write the code once and put it in our PCLs or shared projects. And of course, several wrapper options do exist. In ENT170, we actually have exercises that cover using Xamarin Auth to support, to store our secure data, our secret data. And in today's exercises, we're going to look at a different option. Both are valid options, but the secure storage plugin we're going to use today is actually a little bit more interesting to us when all we want to do is secure storage. Xamarin Auth handles kind of REST calls as well as storage for us. All we need is something to handle the secure storage for us. So this plugin right here is going to be actually probably ideal. Of course, all it does is behind the scenes abstract the APIs that are exposed by iOS, by Android, by Windows. So the very secure APIs that are built right into our operating systems.